Sairam students, I hope you all are fine. Today, let us continue to learn history lesson number 10, New Empires and Kingdoms. Children, in our previous class, we had learned about Prashastis and what they tell us, and about Samudragupta's Prashasti. We know about Samudragupta from a long inscription inscribed on the Ashokan pillar at Allahabad, and it was written by his court poet Harisena. And a prashasti is a Sanskrit word which means in praise of. And Samudragupta's prashasti, it tells us that the king is praised in glowing terms as one who has won victories in battles, and he is also described as equal to the gods. And Harisena, it describes four different kinds of rulers based on the information that is provided in the Prashasti. That is about Aryavarta, Dakshinapatha, inner circle of neighboring states, and about the rulers of the outlying areas. And children, today let us learn about genealogies and about Harshavardhana and the Harshcharita. Now children, let us learn about genealogies. What do you mean by genealogies? Genealogies means lists of ancestors. That means great-grandfather, grandfather, father, the ruler himself, then his son, followed by his son, etc. So, most prashastis, they also mention the ancestors of the ruler. And this one prashasti, it mentions about Samudragupta's great-grandfather, grandfather, and about his father and mother. And his mother, Kumara Devi, she belonged to the Lichhavi Gana, while his father, Chandragupta, he was the first ruler of the Gupta dynasty to adopt the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj, a title that Samudragupta also used. So, who was his mother? Kumara Devi was Samudragupta's mother. And where did she belong to? She belonged to the Lichhavi Gana. And who was his father? Chandragupta was his father. And Chandragupta, he was the first ruler of the Gupta dynasty who adopted the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj. And this grand title, it was also used by Samudragupta. So, Chandragupta and Samudragupta, they had got the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj. And his great-grandfather and grandfather, they are simply mentioned as Maharajas. That means they did not get the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj as Chandragupta and Samudragupta. So, it seems as if the family, it gradually rose to importance. And Samudragupta, he in turn figures in the genealogies. Genealogies means lists of ancestors. That means he mentions about later rulers of the dynasty, such as his son. Who was his son? Chandragupta II. And how do we know about him? We know about him from inscriptions and coins. So, what are his great-grandfather and grandfather simply mentioned as? They are mentioned as Maharajas. And who was Chandragupta II? Chandragupta II was the son of Samudragupta. And how do we know about him? We know about him from inscriptions and coins. And Chandragupta II, he led an expedition to Western India, where he overcame the last of the Shakas. And according to later belief, his court, it had learned people. So, who led an expedition to Western India? Chandragupta II, he led an expedition to Western India. And there, what did he do? He defeated the last of the Shakas. And according to the later belief, his court, it had many learned people. Now children, let us discuss about Vikram Samvat. The era beginning in the 58 BCE is traditionally associated with Gupta King Chandragupta II, who had founded it as a mark of victory over the Shakas and assumed the title of Vikramaditya. So children, what do you mean by Vikram Samvat? It is the era that is beginning in the 58 BCE and it is traditionally associated with the Gupta King. Which Gupta King? Chandragupta II. And what did he do? He had founded it as a mark of victory over the Shakas. That means he had defeated the Shakas. And what title did he get? He assumed the title of Vikramaditya. So Chandragupta II, he is also known as Vikramaditya. Now children, let us learn about Harshavardhana and the Harshacharita. While we can learn about the Gupta rulers from their inscriptions and coins, we can find out about some kings from biographies. Harshavardhana, who ruled nearly 1400 years ago, he was one such ruler. So, how do we come to know about the Gupta rulers? We come to know about the Gupta rulers from their inscriptions and coins. And we can also find out about some kings from biographies. And Harshavardhana, he was one such ruler. And we know that he ruled nearly 1400 years ago. And his court poet Panabatta, he wrote his biography, the Harshacharita, in Sanskrit. And this gives us the genealogy of Harsha and ends with his becoming king. So, who wrote his biography? His court poet Panabatta, he wrote his biography. What is that biography known as? It is known as Harshacharita. And it was written in which language? It was written in Sanskrit. And what does it give us? It gives us the genealogy of Harsha and ends with his becoming king. And we also know about Harshavardhana from Xuanzang. Xuanzang, he was a Chinese traveler and he spent a lot of time at Harsha's court. And he left a detailed account of what he saw. So, who was a Chinese traveler? Xuanzang, he was a Chinese traveler. And he also was a Buddhist monk. And we know about Harshavardhana that he was not the eldest son of his father, but he became the king of Thanissar after both his father and elder brother died. And his brother-in-law, he was the ruler of Kannauj. And he was killed by the ruler of Bengal. So, who became the king of Thanissar? Harshavardhana, he became the king of Thanissar. When? After his father and elder brother died. And who was the ruler of Kannauj? His brother-in-law, he was the ruler of Kannauj. And who killed him? He was killed by the ruler of Bengal. And Harsha, what did he do? He took over the kingdom of Kannauj. And then he led an army against whom? Against the ruler of Bengal. Although he was successful in the east and he conquered Magadha and probably Bengal also, but he was not as successful elsewhere. That is when he tried to cross the Narmada to march into the Deccan. Then at that time he was stopped by a ruler belonging to the Chalukya dynasty. Who was that ruler? He was Pulakeshin II. So who tried to cross the Narmada and wanted to march into the Deccan? Harshavardhana, he tried to cross the Narmada and he wanted to march into the Deccan. But what happened? He was stopped by a ruler belonging to the Chalukya dynasty, Pulakeshin II. Children, we shall learn more about Pulakeshin II in our next class.
Now children, let us recap what we have learned in today's lesson. We learned about genealogies. That is, we come to know about the genealogy of the Guptas from the Prashastis, which mention Samudragupta's great grandfather, grandfather, father and mother. His mother Kumaradevi, she belonged to the Lichchavigana, while his father Chandragupta, he was the first Gupta ruler who adopted the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj. Samudragupta too used that title. His great grandfather and grandfather, they are mentioned simply as Maharajas. And Samudragupta also added the name of his son Chandragupta II in the genealogy. Chandragupta II, he led an expedition to western India where he defeated the last of the Shakas. And we learned about Harshavardhana and the Harshcharita. Harshavardhana, he ruled nearly 1400 years ago. We come to know about him from his biography, which was written by his court poet Banabatta. This biography is known as Harshacharita, which is in Sanskrit. And another source to know about him is Xuan Zhang's account, which he left behind him. And Harshavardhana, he became the ruler of Thanissar after both his father and elder brother died. And he took over the kingdom of Kanauj after his brother-in-law was killed by the ruler of Bengal. Harsha led an army against the ruler of Bengal and he got success in the east and conquered Magadha and probably Bengal also. But he was not as successful elsewhere. He tried to cross the Narmada to march into the Deccan but was stopped by a ruler belonging to the Chalukya dynasty, Pulakeshin II. Now children, let's have a quiz. Multiple choice questions. First one, the son of Samudragupta was Dash. A. Chandragupta, B. Chandragupta II, C. Ashoka. What's the correct answer? Correct. B. Chandragupta II. The son of Samudragupta was Chandragupta II. Second one, the first ruler of the Gupta dynasty to adopt the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj was Dash. A. Samudragupta, B. Chandragupta, C. Skandagupta. What's the correct option? Correct. B. Chandragupta. The first ruler of the Gupta dynasty to adopt the grand title of Maharaj Adhiraj was Chandragupta. Third one, who wrote the biography of Harshavardhana? A. Ravikirti, B. Harishena, C. Banabatta. What's the correct option? Correct. C. Banabatta. Banabatta wrote the biography of Harshavardhana. Fourth one, who tried to cross Narmada to march into Deccan? A. Harshavardhana, B. Banabatta, C. Ashoka. What's the correct answer? Correct. A. Harshavardhana. Harshavardhana tried to cross Narmada to march into Deccan. Fifth one, Harsha's brother-in-law was the ruler of Dash. A. Kanauj, B. Patliputra, C. Ujjain. What's the correct answer? Correct. A. Kanauj. Harsha's brother-in-law was the ruler of Kanauj. Very good children, those who have guessed all the answers correctly.
So children, today we have learnt about genealogies and about Harshavardhana and Harshacharita. Children, we shall learn more about this lesson in our next class. Till we meet again, goodbye children.